And at one time, a little shove is all it would have needed to make this group called the Jitters break up. But now, they're living it up, and for good reason.
The Jitters have lots to celebrate now, but a year ago the picture wasn't quite so rosy. It had been 6 long years of writing songs and touring bars and still no record deal. Their guest of honor here today changed all that. Her name's Nancy Rochon, and the funny part is, she doesn't cut records for a living.
Record producer Paul Gross is a steady customer, and Nancy is a dedicated Jitters fan.
I think there was about maybe 8 songs. I think I had 2 tapes with 4 songs each.
So she was ready with backup material the day Gross heard the band's first broadcast on a rock station.
Well, I had been cutting Paul Gross's hair at home, and the song came on the radio.
It was a local radio contest, and I just thought the material was phenomenal. And immediately wanted to find out if they had a record deal or what the story was, because I'd never really heard of this band. And then when Nancy had given me this tape, I listened to the songs and I couldn't believe that they didn't have a record deal.
Well, now they do, with Capitol Records. Gross produced their first album that's already threatening to go gold. And about now, they're touring Britain. If they had broken up, just what would they have done instead?
I wanted to become a scholar of Canadian arts and letters.
You see, you don't think about things like that. I don't know what I would have done. I would have started another band, maybe.
That I really want to play drums with, but it didn't work out.
Well, I probably would have worked in a shoe store.
Actually, I was going to go back to school.
To take what?
Music.